Hi, Raiders and antagonists. Welcome to a new chapter of Inside Raiders. This program will be very special because I've got Enrique Alvarez, director of Raiders of the Broken Planet, here with me. What's up, Enrique?
I'm doing great. Thanks, Karen.
Well, let's talk about the changes that are about to arrive for the game. As you know, we recently announced that Hades Betrayal, Raiders of the Broken Planet's third premium campaign, will launch on April 4th. This release will be accompanied by a wealth of changes related to the game's progression and reward system that drastically vary the way the game is played. So, Enrique, my first question is, how much has Raiders of the Broken Planet changed since it was released last September?
A great deal. We have literally implemented thousands of changes over the last few months. From tiny things that may seem trivial on their own but make a big difference when combined, to huge sweeping changes inspired by the evolution of the game. Raiders is a mission-driven game and we are still learning how the community plays the game. The community not only give us direct feedback, but we have also been able to gather valuable data about how they play and interact with the characters. We have tweaked the game accordingly. I'm not sure how many updates we've released so far, but they have been very numerous and regular, and that's only the beginning.
Okay, let's get to the main point. What are the most important changes to this new progression system coming in Hades Betrayal?
There are quite a few. I'll try to be brief because I could spend hours talking about what players are going to find. First, the very existence of a progression system is the greatest new feature we are introducing. Until now, Raiders lacked a true progression system. We had something similar, but it didn't quite work. From now on, the game will have a much more defined and easy to understand system. You will start by ranking up, becoming more powerful, and deciding if you want to increase your experience as a raider or as an antagonist. That's what we call affinity. And this will have big consequences to the whole game for everyone. What's also remarkable is that recruiting new characters will now depend on this new progression system, with character prices in gold reduced by half. Yes, that's right, 50% reduction across the board. Not only that, but players will still obtain experience points, faction points, gold, and other rewards as before. But, and this is big news, they are now available to configure weapons to their own liking, based on their experience level. That will add an interesting depth to the game, along with lots of new toys to experiment with too.
That sounds great, but players, both veterans and new, must be wondering how all this will affect them.
Veterans will find that all the content they have unlocked or purchased so far is still there. Characters, cards, skins, weapons, everything will be there as they start this race through the new progression system. New players will enter a totally revamped game, much more accessible than the one we released last September. The truth is that all this time since launch, the game has been in an early access period, with things we did well, but also things we did wrong. And now we are correcting as much as we can, thanks to our loyal community. Players will find out on April the 4th that there is a deluge of improvements coming to Raiders of the Broken Planet, and this is only the start.
So you are saying that player feedback is what has directly inspired all these changes to the game?
We've been working a lot on these changes since day one. This game is a constantly evolving world. Contrary to when you work on a single-player game, where you get feedback from the design team and other studio members, we can now access our players' thoughts and invaluable gaming data directly. And when the feedback is consistent with our game vision, we implement the necessary changes. It must be understood that introducing changes to a project as big as Raiders is not always possible, and when it is, it takes a lot of time and effort to do it properly. I could promise that everyone playing the game will see lots of changes that we are including in a third campaign and beyond. We are listening, and we are committed to delivering what our customers want.
So these won't be the last changes introduced to Raiders?
Exactly. The pace at which we will introduce changes and new content from April the 4th onwards will be dizzying. And I reckon even the most veteran members of our community will be satisfied to see that we have been paying them a lot of attention. I'm sure we will make more mistakes, But at the same time, we'll invest more time, resources, and above all, lots of enthusiasm in correcting them, making Raiders of the Broken Planet the game we always dreamed it to be, a great adventure, where you can spend many hours as a raider or as an antagonist.
Awesome. Well, Enric, thank you so much for your time, and thank you everyone for learning with us about all these major changes that will arrive on April 4th for Raiders of the Broken Planet. We hope you enjoy them, and see you on the Broken Planet.